Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today we are going to start with the second scene, Act 1, Scene 2 of The Merchant of Venice. It is for class 9s and 10s. In Merchant of Venice, in the last scene we have seen that Antonio is a very wealthy merchant, and he is talking to his best friend who want to go to Portia, who lives in Belmont. Now, who is this Portia? We should know something more about Portia also, isn't it? We have come to know this part, Venice, and now we are going to know about Belmont, where we already know who lives. Portia lives over there. Who is Portia? Portia is a rich lady whom Bassanio wants to marry. Okay, Bassanio is raising money to go to Portia's house. Where is Portia's house? Portia's house is in Belmont. Now, in the last scene, we already came to know that huge number of people from different places were coming to Portia, to Belmont, because they wanted to marry Portia. Portia is a rich lady. She was very virtuous also. She was a very good-hearted and very educated person. So, people wanted to marry her. And so they were visiting Belmont from the different parts of the world, as Bassanio has already said to us in the last scene. So now we are going to see what happens in Belmont when the different suitors come to Portia's house with an intention to marry her. See, it is a room in Portia's house. We see Portia and Nerissa. Who is Nerissa? Nerissa is the lady in waiting of Portia. She is both a friend as well as a helping hand to Portia. She is not a maid, she is not a servant, okay? But not as powerful as Portia, or does not have, is not so well accomplished like Portia, but she is obviously not a servant. She is a friend and also a helping hand, you can say. She is a lady in waiting, okay? Now, Portia. What does Portia say? By my troth. You know, the words written in red is the meaning of the word before it. By my troth means, believe me, Nerissa, my little body is aweary. Aweary means tired of this great world. So Portia says to Nerissa that, see, I am very tired of this world. Why is she tired? Nerissa, you would be, sweet madam, if your miseries were in the same abundance as your good fortunes are. So, Portia is very tired of the world. Portia does not like the situation. Why does she not like the situation? Because she feels that she is deprived of her own choice. She cannot choose her own husband because of a particular reason, because of a particular decision made by her father. That is why she cannot choose her own husband. So, she is sad about this plan. Nerissa, you would be, now Nerissa, tries to lift the mood of Portia. You would be, sweet madam, if your miseries, if your problems were in the same abundance, which means equal to your good fortunes. That means, yes, you might have been sad if your problems were equal to the good fortunes. You are so rich. And as much you are rich, you are not sad that much, isn't it? So, it does not suit you to be sad. And yet, for aught, that means for anything I see, they are as sick that surfeit with too much as they that starve with nothing. That means, see, Nerissa says to Portia that those people who surfeit, that means who have a lot of money or who have a lot of happiness, they think that they do not have anything. For example, if you have lakhs and lakhs of money, you still will not be happy with it. You will think that I want more of it. I want more money. I want to be richer. Okay, you will never be happy. When you are very rich, when you have an abundance, when you have a lot of something, you think that you do not have it much. And those as that, they starve with nothing. So two kinds of people are never happy. First one, those who are very rich or who have a lot, okay, and those who have nothing. That means a poor person and a rich person. Both of them are not happy. Then who are happy according to Nerissa? It is no mean happiness, therefore, to be seated in the mean. So, according to Nerissa, those who are in the middle, neither too rich nor too poor. Only those people have the happiness. Because poor people will constantly think, what will I eat tomorrow? I don't have money to buy food for myself tomorrow. So that is why he is always sad. The person who is rich is constantly going on thinking how to, you know, protect that money, how to become richer. Okay, so these two people are never happy. So it is better to be in the middle. That means neither too rich nor too poor. Then superfluity comes sooner by white hairs. What do you mean by superfluity? Superfluity means those who have too much. T-double, okay? Those who have too much come sooner by white hairs. So the people who have a lot of something, that means maybe a lot of money, they become, you know, old very soon, because they are constantly worrying, constantly sad, constantly in tension that what will happen to my money, if my money is stolen or not. They're always worrying. If you have a lot of tension, you will have gray hairs sooner out of stress. That means your hairs will turn white if you are taking a lot of stress. So these kind of people, like Portia, who has a lot of money, they constantly have to worry about it, and that is why they will soon be having white hairs. But competency lives longer. Competency means those who just have enough. Just enough to keep you okay. Okay, you just have enough money to be happy. Neither you are too rich nor you are too poor. You are in the center. Then that those kind of people lives longer. They are happier and they live a happy life. You see, middle class people live a happy life rather than the very rich ones. Okay. Like Ambani and all that, who are very, very rich, and those who are very poor because they do not have money to buy food also. Okay, Portia. So you think, obviously, you can understand from here that Nerissa is quite a clever lady and very wise also. So Portia, good sentences and well pronounced. So Portia says, see, it is obviously very nice. It is obviously very easy to advise something. It is always very easy for a teacher to advise you, dear students, that prepare all your lessons, everyday practice English language and mathematics. But it is very difficult to follow that. Okay. They would be better if well followed. So Nerissa says, if you can follow those advices, those good advices, then it would obviously be better for you. Portia, if to do were no what sorry if to do were as easy as to know what were good to do, chapels had been churches. Okay, so what does Portia say? Portia says, if it was easy to follow the advice that is given, then easily, what do you mean by chapels? Chapels means the small churches. The small churches, like this, this is the picture of a chapel. The small churches would soon become big churches. Okay, the chapels would soon become big churches, but it is not that easy to follow the advice. Teachers can say that you study and you practice daily, but it is difficult when you are told to follow it, when you have to follow that same thing, okay, the same advice. What else did she say? And poor men's cottages, princes' palaces. If advices would have been so easy to follow, then though you see the chapels would become churches, the small places would become huge places, poor men would soon become as rich as princes, okay, like kings, sons and daughters, okay, and poor men's houses would become palaces. Okay, you are told to practice, you are told to work hard, but it is difficult to work hard, isn't it? It is difficult to work hard throughout the year so that you can score good marks. It is difficult. It is a good divine, that means it is a good preacher or a good teacher that follows his own instructions. It often happens that the person who is advising you to do certain things, that person also will find it difficult to follow his own advice. If I tell you, practice hard, and if I have to practice hard for my own exam, then it would be difficult for myself to follow that same advice. Understood? I can easier teach 20 what were good to be done than be one of the 20 to follow mine own teaching. So she says that, see, if I have to advise 20 people what they have to do, it would become easier. But if I have to follow the same advice that I have given, then it would be difficult for me. The brain may devise laws for the blood. So brain can tell you before the exam it happens, no? Brain tells you, see, this is what is the law then that you will have to sit and study. But the blood, you know, young people, they have a very youthful spirit. They are always with a lot of energy. They are always running like a hare, such a hare. So youthful people, that is young people, are like the hare, the rabbits, who are always in high spirits. They're always jumping, and without thinking, they go on, they're jumping around, doing this, that, without thinking. Okay. Is madness the youth to skip over the meshes? Meshes means nets of good counsel, of good advice. So young people are like rabbits. They always jump around. They are always excited. They do not want to follow what the brain is telling them to do. They do not want to follow, even if the brain tells them, their own brain is telling them, go and sit and study. Your exam is here. But they don't want to follow it because their blood is warm. Okay, they have a lot of energy. Blood warm means they have a lot of energy and they want to jump around, play around, okay, enjoy their life. And they will not listen to their own brain, which tells them to study. Okay. But this reasoning is not in fashion to choose me a husband. Then again, she starts thinking, Portia starts thinking. She's sad again. Why? Because she suddenly remembers, why do I need to think about all these things? See, I cannot even choose my own husband. Oh me, the word choose. She feels sad when she uses the word choose because she is deprived. She is not given this power to choose. What will she choose? What she cannot choose over here? She cannot choose her own husband. I may neither choose whom I would, nor refuse whom I dislike. So, her father has made a plan, such a plan, where she has no role to play. She cannot choose her own husband. She cannot decide whether she likes this person or not. Okay, whoever can do what her father has said will surely marry her. Okay, she has no say in that thing, whether she wants to marry that person or not. Now, what is the plan of her father? So is the will of a living daughter curbed. Curbed means it is restrained or it is cut short by the will of a dead father. Her father is dead. Portia's father is dead. But Portia's father's plan is working still. And in that manner only she will be married off. Is it not hard, Nerissa, that I cannot choose one nor refuse none? So many suitors are coming. They are going to participate in the game that is planned by Portia's father, and if they can win the game, then they will marry Portia, and Portia has no say in it. If Portia does not like that person who won the game, then also she has to marry that person. Okay, she cannot refuse him. She cannot refuse that person who has won the game. Okay, she has to marry him. Nerissa, your father was ever virtuous. That means Nerissa says that, see, your father was a very wise person. And holy men at their death have good inspirations. And your father was already wise. And you know, when you grow old, you become wiser. With time, you gain a lot of experiences and you become wiser. So your father had grown wiser with his age. Therefore, the lottery, this is the game that was planned. Therefore, the lottery that he hath devised, that means which he has thought upon, in these three chests of gold, silver and lead, whereof he chooses, meaning you will never, no doubt, chosen by rightly, but anyone who shall rightly love. Okay, so what does this mean over here? It means that whoever chooses the right casket, that means there were three caskets. What were the colors? Gold, silver, and lead casket. There were three caskets. Okay, gold, silver, and lead. So caskets look like this. They are boxes, okay, that were made of gold. One was made of gold, one was made of silver, and one was made of lead. There were three caskets. It is kind of a box and there is a place inside. What was the lottery? If you are asked this question, what was the lottery? The lottery stated that in one of these caskets, in the gold, silver, and lead caskets, three caskets would be given in front. And in one of these caskets, there is the portrait of Portia. Okay, it is inside the casket. Now, by looking from outside, you have to choose in which casket Portia's portrait can be. Okay, And if you choose it correctly, when you have, for example, if I want to marry Portia and I decide to choose, and I choose the silver casket. Now they will open and see it, okay? And if they find Portia's portrait inside it, then he will be given to marry Portia. Otherwise, he cannot marry Portia. Okay, that was the plan. So according to Nerissa, the person who rightly loves Portia, he will be the person who can choose the correct casket, because Portia's father was quite wise. So he must have planned this thing wisely so that the right person for Portia is given to marry her. Okay. But what warmth is there in your affection towards any of these princely suitors that are already come? Now Nerissa asks Portia, what do you think, or what idea or what opinion do you have about the suitors, about the people who have come to marry you, who have come to choose, play this lottery game, and has an intention to marry you? What do you think about all those people? What opinion do you hold about all those suitors? Okay. So now Portia says, I pray thee, that means I ask you, overname them. Overname them means call out their names, call out the names of the suitors. And as thou means as you namest, means as you name them, I will describe them. Which means as you call out their names, I will tell what I feel about these suitors. And according to my description, leaven, that means guess, my affection. As I go on telling you how I feel about these people, I go on describing the suitors who have come, you will easily understand how I feel about them. Okay. Nerissa. First, there is the Neapolitan prince. Who is a Neapolitan prince? Neapolitan prince means a prince of Naples. Naples is a particular place. So the prince of Naples is the Neapolitan prince. So Nerissa asks her, what do you think about the Neapolitan prince who has come as a suitor? Portia. Ah, that's a colt. That's a colt means is a young horse. Over here, you can also say that particularly he means he's a young person. But why does she use the word colt? Because of a reason. See, what is the reason? Indeed, for he doth means does nothing but talk of his horse. So why does she call Neapolitan prince a colt? Because this person, the Neapolitan prince, is always talking about his horse. Okay, and he makes it a great appropriation to his own good parts. So this means that he thinks that it is a very good quality in him that he can shoe him himself. What do you mean by shoeing a horse? I think all of you should know this. Horses have a metal kind of a thing attached to their feet. Okay? In all the four foot they have. In all of it, a metal piece is attached to it. That is called the shoeing of a horse. When you put that metal piece on the horse's feet, that is called the shoeing of a horse. Now, the Neapolitan prince was very proud that he could do this work. He could shoe, that means he could put the iron piece to its leg, attach the iron piece to its feet himself. He did not require any blacksmith or anybody to put it there. He could himself do it. So, he was so fascinated about himself that he could do this work himself that he thinks, that Portia thinks, I much afeard my lady, his mother played false with the smith. So Portia thinks that how is it possible that a prince, a king's son, is so proud that he can shoe his horse himself? It might have been so that this Neapolitan prince's mother had played false or had done some bad thing or performed some extramarital affair with the blacksmith, and that is why this son, the Neapolitan prince, was actually the son of the blacksmith, and so he was very interested in working as a blacksmith. Okay. Next, Nerissa. Then there is the Count Palatine. So what do you think about this Count Palatine? Who is the Count Palatine? The count means the local ruler of which place? Palatinate. Okay. Now, what do you think about this County Palatine? Portia says, he doth nothing but frown. This is the character of County Palatine. Always frowning, always with a scorn, always unhappy. Okay. as who should say, if you will not have me, choose. So he is always with an attitude that, okay, fine, if you don't choose me, then it's fine. Then what might have happened? I don't bother. It does not matter me. Okay. He hears merry tales. That means although you tell him a lot of jokes and he will not smile, smiles not. You tell him jokes, he will not smile. I fear. So you can tell him he had a vinegar aspect just like Antonio. Okay. In the last scene we have done now. I fear he will prove the weeping philosopher. See why philosophers are always sad and depressed. See, a philosopher knows the world better than us, than the common people. So when these philosophers see the foolishness of the common people, they become sad by seeing the stupidity of the common people. And that is why they remain always depressed and sad. Okay. So when he grows old, being so full of unmannerly sadness in his youth. So, according to Portia, this man is already so sad and depressed when he is young. So, when he will grow old, he will become a weeping philosopher. He will become sadder, isn't it? He will become more sad when he grows old. With time, with experiences, he will grow more sad with time. Okay. Next. I had rather be married to a death's head. What is a death's head? See, a death's head with a bone in his mouth than to either of these. So he says, so Portia says that I would better marry a death's head. Death's head means this one. You often see, you know, danger zone has this kind of a mark. So I would better marry a skull with the bones in its mouth rather than marrying these two. That means he does not wish to marry the County Palatine, number one. And number two, whom does she not wish to marry? Also this Neapolitan prince. She does not wish to marry any of them. Okay. So we get an idea about the Neapolitan prince as well as the County Palatine. Then what does she say? God defend me from these two. So please help me, God, so that I don't have to marry the Neapolitan prince or this County Palatine. Okay. Nerissa now asks, how say you by the French lord, Monsieur Le Bon Monsieur? This word tells you that this is a French man. Okay. So what do you think about this French lord who has come? God made him and therefore let him pass for a man. See, God has made this man as a human being. So that is why I will call him a man. This is a, you know, this is a taunt that I don't want to call this person, this French man, a real person. This is such a stupid man. In truth, I know it is sin to be a mocker. Mocker means Portia very well knows that you should not mock anybody. You should not make fun of anybody. But he, why he had a horse better than the Neapolitans? So this person has a horse which is better than the Neapolitans. A better bad habit of frowning than the County Palatine. He is every man in no man. You can be asked this question, okay? Every man in no man. This Frenchman has, you know, copied characteristics of everybody. From different people, he has copied their characters. Maybe he talks like somebody, he smiles like somebody, he writes like somebody. Okay, so he has qualities of everybody and therefore he does not have any uniqueness. There is no unique behavior in him, no unique quality in him. So marrying him would be marrying everybody because he has copied everybody. Okay, if a throstle, that means throstle is a bird, thrush, it is mainly generally called a thrush. So when he hears a thrush, that is a bird who is singing, when he hears a bird singing, he falls straight a capering. Straight a capering means he starts jumping and dancing to the music, to the song sung by the bird. That means Portia wants to point out that he is stupid, he copies others' natures, qualities. He will fence. Okay, fence means he will fight with his own shadow. He is so stupid that when he sees his own shadow, he would think that this is his enemy and he starts fighting with that person. Okay, if I should marry him, then she says that if I am given to marry him, I should marry 20 husbands. So if I marry him, I would be marrying 20 people at a time because he is a copy of everybody everywhere. Okay, if he would despise, that means if he would hate me, if he would hate Portia, I would forgive him. I can easily forgive him because For if he love me to madness, I shall never requite him. So, according to Portia, she will never be able to love this person, this Frenchman. So, it would be better if the Frenchman hates Portia. Okay? Because if he loves Portia, then she would not be able to return his love. Okay? Larissa. What say you then to Falconbridge, the young Baron of England? Now comes a young Baron of which place? Of England. Portia says, you know, I say nothing to him. You see, I don't say anything to him, for he understands not me, because this person, this Englishman, does not understand me. Why? Nor I him. That means neither this Englishman can understand Portia, nor can Portia understand the Englishman. Why? What is the problem? He hath neither Latin, French, nor Italian, and you will come into the court and swear that I have a poor pennyworth, that means very little knowledge in English. See, if I cannot speak in English, and if you cannot, maybe I know only Bengali, and you don't know Bengali, you know only English. Then how is it possible if we don't have a common language, how is it possible for us to communicate? It's not possible. With gestures, by waving hands and making signs, I will have to talk to you. And it is not possible to talk for long, isn't it? How long can you do gestures and explain? Okay. So, because we do not have a common language, we cannot talk. I do not know English. Portia does not know English. And this Englishman does not know any other language other than English. He does not know Latin, French, or Italian. And I don't know anything other than these three languages. Okay. So, we do not have a common language, and that is why we cannot speak to each other. What else do we come to know about him? He is a proper man's picture, so he looks nice. But alas, who can converse with a dumb show? You cannot go on gesturing and making signs, isn't it? You have to have a language to speak. So, a dumb show cannot go on. You cannot go on gesturing to one another. How oddly he is suited. Moreover, he has such a bad choice of clothing. See, he has bought his doublet. What is doublet? It is a jacket. So, the jacket that he is wearing is from Italy. His round hose, that means tight slacks or pants, it is a tight fitting dress. So, he wears that one from France. His bonnet, which means the hat, is from Germany, and his behavior everywhere. So, the style, the clothes that he wears is so strange. The doublet is from Italy, the pant is from France, the hat is from Germany, and behavior is from everywhere. So, he also has a very strange taste. Okay, Nerissa, what think you of the Scottish lord, his neighbor? So, what do you think about the Scottish lord, Scotland? So, obviously, England and Scotland are almost very close to each other. So, the Scottish person, the person, the lord from Scotland, what do you think about him? Portia says, that he hath a neighborly charity. See, this person, the Scottish man, has a kind of neighborly charity. That means has a very forgiving nature. He can forgive anybody for anything. Who? That Scottish lord. For he borrowed a box of the ear of the Englishman. That means once upon a time what happened? This is just a joke made by Portia. That you see, once upon a time, this English and the Scotland, the people, the Scotland and the England, these two places were constantly, you know, fighting with one another, and there was constant problem with each other, and the French people used to help the people of Scotland to get over it, get over the problems. So now what Portia says, just mockingly, she says that I think this person from Scotland has a very forgiving nature. He can forgive everything. So once when the Englishman had given a box of the ear, that means had hit his ear, okay, had slapped him, then he had forgiven the Englishman, okay, and swore he would pay him again when he was able. That means he was unable to hit him, okay, in return. That is why he said that after some time I will surely pay this debt off. That means after some time when I become stronger, I will hit you. Okay. Now, how will he become stronger? I think the Frenchman became his surety. So, he says so Portia says that I think that Frenchman will help him. The Frenchman has always helped the people of Scotland. So, this French people assisted the Scots in their fights with the Englishmen, and sealed under for another. So they used to help each other. So perhaps this Frenchman, who is one of my suitor, will help the Scottish person to, for what? To slap him, just like the Englishman had slapped the Scottish. Okay. Next, Nerissa. How like you, the young German, the Duke of Saxony's nephew? Now, what do you have to tell about this young German? Portia says, very wildly bad in the morning when he is sober, most wildly in the afternoon when he is drunk. The problem with the German is he is a drunkard. He always drinks. Because he is always in a drunken state, he misbehaves. He is a very awful person. Okay. When he is best, he is a little worse than a man. And when he is worst, he is a little better than a beast. That means when he is not in his drunken state, then also he is such an awful person that we cannot call him a man. Okay. And when he is in a drunken state, when he has just drunk some wine, you know, then also he can be called just like a beast. Okay. He's almost like a beast. Clear? And the worst fall that ever fell, I hope I shall make shift to go without him. So I just hope I don't have to marry this drunkard. I don't want to marry a drunkard at least. Nerissa, if he should offer to choose, so if he should offer to choose and choose the right casket means, if this person, this drunkard, chooses the right casket, then you should refuse to perform your father's will if you refuse to accept him. Then it will become a problem, because if you then refuse to marry the drunkard, then it would be such that you are going against your father's wish, isn't it? So that would be bad. Portia, therefore, for fear of the worst, I pray thee, set a deep glass of Rhenish wine. Now, Portia has a plan so that she does not have to marry this drunkard. What is the plan? For fear of the worst. So to avoid the worst thing, that to avoid me being married to this drunkard, I have a plan. I pray thee, that means I request you, set a deep glass of Rhenish wine. Rhenish wine means white wine. You do one thing on the contrary casket. If my portrait is in the lead casket, you put a glass of Rhenish wine, maybe in the other any of the other caskets, maybe in the gold casket. It is the wrong casket. My portrait is not there. You place a glass of Rhenish wine, white wine, inside this casket. What will happen? For if the devil be within and that temptation without, I know he will choose it. I will do anything, Nerissa, ere means before, I will be married to a sponge. Sponge means drunkard. See, I want to avoid my marriage to a drunkard. So what I tell you, I have a plan. You put a glass of wine inside the wrong casket. And this drunkard will surely, always a drunkard is very fond of wine and drinks, isn't it? Hard drinks. So by the scent, the scent of that wine, he would choose the wrong casket, because in the wrong casket, a glass of wine is given. So he will choose the wrong casket and I would be saved from marrying this drunkard. Sponge means the drunkard. Nerissa, you need not fear, lady, the having any of these lords. They have acquainted, that means they have informed me, with their determinations, that means decisions, which is indeed to return to their home and to trouble you with no more suits. So what does Nerissa say? Nerissa says that all these suitors, you don't have to think about any of them, because they have given me, they have told me about their decision. What is their decision? That they would not bother you with they would not pester you, they would not stay back over here, because unless you may be won by some other sort that your father's imposition conditions depending on the caskets. So they don't want to choose the casket and take a chance. It was a lottery game almost. So they don't want to participate in the lottery game, because there are some conditions also. That if somebody decides to choose this lottery, then if he chooses the wrong casket, he will not be able to marry ever in his life. Now, that is a very bad condition, isn't it? If he cannot marry Portia, from henceforth, he will not be marrying anybody. He will remain a bachelor. That will become a difficult thing for him. That is why, after hearing this condition, they decided not to participate in the lottery game. Therefore, all the six suitors have gone back, decided to go back. Portia, if I live to be as old as Sibylla, I will die as just as Diana, unless I be obtained by the manner of my father's will. Before we understand what is written in this part, first we will know these two characters, as old as Sibylla and Diana. Who is Sibylla? The prophetess. She is a prophetess, a female prophet. So this Sibylla was blessed by Apollo. Who is Apollo? The Roman god. Listen carefully. This Roman god blessed him. He said that the number of sand that you can hold in your palm, okay, that many years you will be living. You will not die. Okay. So you hold the number of sands you can hold in your hand. It is quite like the number of hairs in your head, isn't it? Uncountable. So it meant that Sibylla will have an eternal life. She will almost never die. Okay. So he granted her as many years of life as the number of grains of sand she could hold in her palm. Okay. So the Roman god Apollo had given him a boon, a blessing. And who is this one? Goddess Diana. Goddess Diana was the goddess of virginity, goddess of hunting, goddess of moon. This is Goddess Diana. Okay, now we come to know. Now come back to this. If I live to be as old as Sibylla, now obviously Sibylla had got a blessing from Apollo. She would be able to live for a huge number of years. So according to Portia, even if she is as old as Sibylla, she will remain virgin. She will never be able to marry anybody if nobody can follow his father's will. Okay, that means if for example nobody is able to choose the correct casket, then what will happen? Although Portia becomes as old as Sibylla, very 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 old, then also she would remain a virgin. She would not be able to marry anybody because she cannot go against her father's will, isn't it? She has to marry as her father has asked her to. Clear? So now, I am glad this parcel of wooers, so Portia finds this a very happy thing that finally all these stupid suitors are going away. I don't like any of them. And for there is not one among them, but I dote on his very absence. So there is not even a single person among these suitors whom I like. I don't like anybody of these six. I pray God grant them a fair departure. So she says that may they go to their own places safely, and I am so satisfied that finally these suitors are going away. I will not have to be afraid that if by chance any of these suitors choose the correct casket, then I have to marry these stupid people. Okay. Nerissa, do you not remember, lady, in your father's time, a Venetian, this part is important, a Venetian, that means a person from Venice, a scholar and a soldier, that came hither. Hither means came here. In company of Marqua of Montferrat. So Marqua of Montferrat means the title of an Italian nobleman. So do you remember of a person from Venice who is also a scholar and a soldier who had come to Belmont with one of his friend, one of the Italian noblemen? So Nerissa asks this to whom? To Portia. That do you remember that person, that Venetian? Who is this Venetian? Can you guess? Portia, yes, yes, it was Bassanio. She very well remembers, Portia remembers that yes, that person is Bassanio. And I think he was so called, yes, I know for sure. True, madam, he of all the men that ever my foolish eyes looked upon was the best deserving a fair lady. So Nerissa thinks that Bassanio is a very noble person, is a good-hearted man, and he is a very suitable person to marry Portia. Portia, I remember him well. Portia says, yes, I also know him very well, and I remember him worthy of thy praise. I also remember that he is a very noble man and very good-hearted man. Enter a serving man. Now a servant enters. How now, what news? Portia asks, now what is the news again? Servant, the four strangers seek for you, madam, to take their leave. So although this thing is written four, actually six were there, isn't it? There were six suitors who were returning. So the six strangers, the six suitors are going to bid farewell to you. They are calling you. And there is a forerunner. What is the other reason for which he has come? The servant has come. There is a forerunner who is coming. A messenger has come from a fifth, that means now another suitor has come, who is Prince of Morocco, that means an African prince, who brings word the prince, his master, will be here tonight. So why has the messenger come? The messenger wants to inform Portia that his master has come. Who is his master? His master is Prince of Morocco. Morocco is a place in Africa. Now, Portia is a bit of a racist. Racist is a person who, you know, who differentiates in according to the skin complexion. She immediately starts thinking, yes, that one is an African. He must have a very dark skin and he must be looking like a devil. I don't like the black skin person. Okay, Portia. If I could bid the fifth welcome with so good a heart as I can bid the other four farewell, I should be glad of his approach. What does she mean from here? Portia means that I cannot welcome this fifth one also. I am very happy that the other six suitors are going away, but the next one also I don't want to meet. I hate him also. I want him to return from here only. If he have the condition of a saint, that if he has a saint-like nature and the complexion, that means the skin color of a devil, I had rather he should shrive. This one shows that she's a racist. She says that if this person, this African prince, has a dark skin tone, is black in color, then I would wish that I do not wish to be his wife, but if he would be just a priest. Shrive means somebody who will hear your faults, your faults, and will forgive you. That means if he is a priest-like person, saint-like person, that would be better for me, because I don't want to marry this person who is dark skin color, of the dark skin color, who has a darker complexion. Come, Larissa, Sira, go before, whilst we shut the gate upon one wooer, another knocks at the door. So when I am trying to bid farewell to these six suitors, another one has come to disturb me. So she becomes all the more frustrated again. Okay, you can have a bit of an idea that this Portia has a kind of feeling for Bassanio. Perhaps the way she suddenly reacts that yes, 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 I know Bassanio. What does this tell you? That Portia kind of likes Bassanio, and she is sad that although she loves somebody, she cannot marry that person because her father has decided upon a casket choice, and according to the person and according to that only she will have to marry. She cannot choose her own husband. So she will not be able to marry Bassanio if Bassanio does not come to choose the casket and ultimately choose the right casket. Okay, so that makes Portia all the more sad. Okay, so exit means it is exit. So they both go away. We have seen a part of Venice and a part of Belmont in Act 1, Scene 2. So we have seen both the sides, and these are the places where the whole play is going to take place mostly. And I guess this part is easier and clearer than the first part. The first part is a bit difficult. You have to be careful with the questions. Okay. And if you have your Xavier Pinto book, the workbook, you can solve from there if you have any questions. If you cannot answer any questions particularly, you can obviously come and ask in the comment section. Thank you so much. If you have liked my video, please comment and subscribe.